Hi everyone. Today, we will learn how to add, edit, and remove closed captions in ActivePresenter 7. Closed captions, or so-called CCs, are a text version shown on televisions, movies, videos or presentations, which display what is being said inside. They are exactly like the subtitles you often see during a movie. I'm going to work with a video that I have created here. It talks about basic ways to create a smart art graphic in PowerPoint. Suppose that I want to add closed captions to that video to help audiences easily follow some actions. To do that, in the timeline, place the playhead at the timestamp where you want to add a closed caption. You can click the Annotations tab and select Closed Caption. Alternatively, I prefer clicking the Insert Caption button, which has the same function in the timeline pane. After doing that, one CC line is inserted at the playhead position. On the canvas, this is a closed caption editor which allows you to type the caption. Okay, done. Furthermore, it's possible to add as many closed captions as you want. Before doing that, make sure to position the playhead to another timestamp and then repeat the cycle. As you can see, there is no overlapping in time between CC lines, which means that only one CC line can be displayed at a time. Another way to add closed captions is importing them from a caption file. To do that, go to the Annotations tab, click the arrow next to the Closed Caption button, choose from File and select the file you want. Note that ActivePresenter supports only SRT file format for closed caption. Therefore, make sure to create SRT file before importing. After adding or importing closed captions, their start time and duration by default may be inappropriate. In that case, ActivePresenter offers two ways to change these properties. Before doing that, in the timeline, place the playhead at the timestamp that the CC line appears. This makes the CC line visible on the canvas, allowing you to see exactly which CC line you are working with. To change start time and duration, the first and easiest way is dragging the CC line or its ends along the timeline ruler. Or you can also set values from the timing section in the Size and Properties tab. You should display each CC line for adequate time so that your audience can read it comfortably. ActivePresenter also offers text-to-speech feature. By using this feature, you can convert closed captions to speech with ease. See our tutorial using text-to-speech for more information. Let's see the preview. If you are not satisfied with default caption style, you can also change it the way you want. To start, don't forget to drag the playhead in the timeline to let the CC line appear on the canvas. So easy to edit the text or the fill style using options available in the Home tab or Format tab. In addition, in the Properties pane, in the Style and Effects tab, there are further style settings such as type, transformation, color, or transparency. You need to bear in mind that you are not able to make a unique look for each CC line. If you change the style of one CC line in a slide, the change will affect all CC lines in that slide and in other slides in the same project. In case users want to show or hide the closed captions, can they do that? The answer is totally yes. ActivePresenter gives users control over showing or hiding closed caption by enabling the CC button in the player. To enable the CC button in the player, click the Export tab first. Select Player Settings. The Player Settings window will pop up and show further settings. In the General tab, select the CC button checkbox in the Toolbar section. Once the CC button checkbox is selected, ActivePresenter automatically adds a CC button to the player, which allows users to toggle the closed caption as they wish. After that, don't forget to click OK to save change. Let's see how does it work. In case you don't want to use CC anymore, in the Timeline pane, click CC line to select it and press Delete. To remove all CC lines in a slide, just click the closed caption name to select all lines and press Delete. So, hope it'll help. Thanks for watching.